champion. Following is a lumberjack match scheduled for
one fall,
making its way to the ring, weighing in at 323 pounds, it's the World Heavyweight Champion, Kane.
You know, Kane was watching earlier tonight and saw what his brother, The Undertaker, did to CM Punk. Next, the Big Red Monster looks to send a message of his own.
Yeah, ladies and gentlemen, it is our main event on the season premiere of SmackDown. Kane versus John Cena and Nexus as Lumberjacks will surround the ring live next on Sci-Fi. We are back live on the season premiere of Friday Night SmackDown here on Sci-Fi. This is our main event. Kane set for action. The five members of Nexus will surround the ring as Lumberjacks as Kane prepares to meet for the first time ever on SmackDown, John Cena. Matt, the Lumberjacks will be used for
the roles of the Lumberjacks, basically to keep the guys in the ring. When they spill out to the floor, throw them back in.
Kane for the first time ever. He'll be meeting Nexus this Sunday night, or wait, they're of Nexus. And Michael, if John Cena loses that match, he'll be wearing black and gold the next time we see him.
I had the opportunity to speak to John Cena earlier today. This is a very emotional weekend for John. Remember, John Cena started his career in WWE right here on Friday Night SmackDown. He has come home tonight. So his first focus is Kane. His next focus is Wade Barrett on Sunday.
If you've never seen John Cena before, expect to see a superstar who won't go away, who won't stay down, who won't quit. John Cena causes traffic jams everywhere we go because he stops and signs autographs for every last person. Personally, it makes me sick, Michael.
What about Kane? If you haven't seen Kane before, what do you expect out of the world champ?
Kane is the demon seed of Paul Bearer, Cecil B. Demented, trying to escape the shadow of his brother, The Undertaker.
He's also a two-time and current world champion. Will defend his title against The Undertaker inside Hell in a Cell.
So much at stake, sorry, Matt, in this matchup here tonight. Neither of these men can afford an injury. Kane heading into Hell in a Cell versus The Undertaker and John Cena with the ever-important match against that man you saw on the left-hand part of your screen, Wade Barrett.
Oh! 7 feet tall, 300 pounds, the Big Red Monster going for an early cover here against John Cena.
And if you're just joining us here tonight live in Oklahoma City, ladies and gentlemen, want to remind you that Wade Barrett of Nexus will meet John Cena on Sunday. If John Cena loses, he must join Nexus. If he wins, Nexus will disband forever.
And Matt, what's it like for John Cena right now, knowing not only is he facing the world champion, but he has Nexus lurking around the ring?
Well, John Cena is always a competitor. He's aware of everything at all times. But what I'm thinking about is, what would it be like if John Cena joins the Nexus? It'll be like, hang on, cover here.
Hooking the leg, Kane.
It's like General Petraeus joining the Infidels. I mean, just stop and think. Look at how powerful Nexus is now. Imagine them with John Cena.
And the other thing, and the other side of this, guys, is the fact that if John Cena has to join Nexus, the WWE loses its leader against Nexus. Cena has been at the forefront of this charge against this group since the beginning back in early summer.
Many consider Cena to be the face of WWE.
Okay, now, here's where the Lumberjacks are supposed to.
Well, come on, you knew that wasn't gonna happen.
They're supposed to just put their opponent back into the ring, but the Nexus have an agenda.
This is the second time tonight that Nexus has ganged up here on John Cena.
And not only John Cena, but Big Show as well.
And Kane is fully aware of the sharks that lurk outside. Looks like Kane's just gonna send John Cena out. How will John Cena come back? We'll find out when the season premiere of SmackDown on Sci-Fi continues next. Oh!
We are back in our main event on the season premiere of Friday Night SmackDown here on Sci-Fi. Kane versus John Cena, first time ever on this program. Nexus
Lumberjacks at ringside.
There you see the leader of Nexus, Wade Barrett, has been given carte blanche from the president of our new network, Sci-Fi, to make matches tonight. And Wade Barrett strategically made John Cena versus Kane, perhaps to soften up John Cena for this Sunday, Todd.
Both these athletes have huge matches in 48 hours in Dallas, Texas, at Hell in a Cell. Kane defending the World Heavyweight Championship against The Undertaker. John Cena facing Wade Barrett. And if Cena loses, Michael, he'll be wearing a Nexus shirt on Monday Night Raw.
Yeah, but if Cena wins, Nexus disbands forever. And John Cena, and there's an uppercut by Kane. Now, the Lumberjacks at ringside supposed to toss the guys back in the ring as they go outside. You might have wondered moments ago why Nexus, after beating up Cena, sent him back into the ring. Well, because they know what Kane, the demented Kane, is capable of.
The 300-pounder from the top rope. Nobody home as Cena starts to quicken the pace.
Yeah, there's that never-say-die attitude of John Cena. Vintage Cena with the flying shoulder blocks.
Oh, Kane is over 300 pounds.
What strength, power, and determination from John Cena.
John Cena off the five-knuckle shuffle. You see John Cena building momentum here against Kane. Looking to put Kane away. Could be AA time. Attitude adjustment. And what an elbow. Uh-oh.
And now Kane trying to do what his brother did earlier tonight with a chokeslam. But Cena powers out. And now over goes Big Kane.
And now let's see what the Lumberjacks do with Kane out here. And they back off. Respect for the champ.
Wait. And now Cena, right after Nexus.
Well, Gabriel just bounced into Kane, and Kane's had enough. Barrett's down, Gabriel's down. And Cena being dragged out.
And now Cena's gonna be down too, maybe not.
Trying to fight back as well as Cena. Looking to lay waste to Nexus.
Well, John knows he's in a fight come this Sunday, and the stakes are high at Hell in a Cell.
Cena watching his back, watching. Uh-oh.
And there he is, the dead man, the Fiend on the Undertaker, and he's going toe-to-toe with the world champion.
So many questions that are going to be answered on Sunday. Undertaker, is he powerful enough to slay his brother?
Well, it's been a brother betrayed. It's been a life of lies. A father's return. All make up the elements that will shake the cages of Hades.
Oh, look out.
Sunday.
Look out now. Kane right across the table in front of him.
Kane flat on his back now. The dead man's not done.
And Undertaker, it is complete chaos out here at ringside. Undertaker hammering away at Kane.
Except this chaos will be contained inside of callous steel.
Yeah, on Sunday they are going to be contained in that five-ton steel cell that can be used as a weapon at every turn.
If there were any questions about The Undertaker's mental or physical well-being, they're being answered and how tonight.
And Matt, what I'm finding interesting here is the fact that Kane is actually reeling. Kane is on his heels. Undertaker's on the attack for the first time against his brother in who knows how long.
Who is the more sadistic brother? Who is capable of more malice? Ask yourself that question.
Well, remember, Undertaker told Kane, little brother, you learned everything from me.
Well, Kane has claimed to be the bigger and now dominant brother, but that does not appear to be the case here tonight.
Kane just trying to survive at this moment against a rejuvenated Undertaker. And again, expression changing on Kane. The demented one is back in it.
One of these brothers will be the orchestrators of destruction, kind of like Jigsaw from the Saw movies. Who is more psychotic?
Well, Kane's plan finally blossomed after 10 years, becoming the world champion and seemingly overcoming his brother. But now, The Undertaker is back on top.
It's been 13 years for Kane to unfold his plan, to unfold his of taking control of the Holy Grail, taking control of the family from the brother.
Well, Kane said he spotted a weakness from The Undertaker at WrestleMania against Shawn Michaels. Has that weakness remained, or is The Undertaker 100%?
Well, whatever Paul Bearer did last week when he returned with the urn, it has unleashed an Undertaker that we have not seen since WrestleMania. The Undertaker left it in a weakened state, in a coma on Memorial Day weekend. Is it a distant past?
Ooh.
Is Undertaker's unloading on Kane?
Those shots, Kane can't even defend himself.
The Undertaker has vowed to reclaim what he feels is rightfully his. The Holy Grail, he calls it, the World Heavyweight Championship.
Well, they say we hurt the ones we love the most, but where is The Undertaker's desire? Is it for revenge, or is it for the World Heavyweight Championship?
And this battle goes so much deeper than just the world title.
Whoa.
This is about blood. This is about revenge. This is about ego. This is about destruction.
Did you see the fear in Kane's eyes? Kane could not believe what he just saw from The Undertaker.
Well, fear makes men do heinous things.
Notice Paul Bearer. Notice Paul Bearer with the urn in the corner. Undertaker.
Undertaker sees the urn.
Look at this, overpowering his brother.
And now The Undertaker locks his brother in, loaded, and he's down. A choke slam to the world champion.
Unthinkable. Just weeks ago. Unstoppable. Tonight. And Kane has had enough.
But this Sunday, there'll be nowhere to run, nowhere to hide. Locked inside Hell in a Cell.
It's not over, big brother. I'm gonna finish you. It's not over.
What a demented evening it's going to be Sunday. It is called the Devil's Playground, ladies and gentlemen, for a reason. It is named after that man, The Undertaker.